那个 YouTube 可以开始了。So, good evening, no good morning, depends on where you are. 大家晚上好，早上好。那个 YouTube 可以开始了。我们本来今天是说不上课的，不过我觉得还是因为万博城没有在打气啊，所以我想还是上上课好了。So originally we planned not to have class, but that time I thought because CDB doesn't have one session, so it's probably better to still have the class. So we'll beside Grandstand to start，那我们还是照往例一样，还是送关于不少的讯号。观世音菩萨，观世音菩萨，观世音。菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，观世音。菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊。菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，观世音菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊。菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊。菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨来了，摩诃世尊，菩萨。今天我们不谈四十二章经，讲谈一个不同的题材。是临终关怀，So we are not going to discuss the Sutra in 42 sections today. We'll talk about totally different topic, caring for the dying. 那为什么会想到谈这个问题？因为我们法总有一个道场，他们要我金融去跟他们谈谈这个问题。是在线上谈这个问题，所以准备的 slide 都准备好了，所以我就想说，那既然都准备好了，也许也可以在这个课上谈一谈，因为这是一个很重要的问题。So the reason why start decided to talk about this topic is because that very recently one of our branches asked me to give an online talk on this topic. So I got the slides prepared, and I thought this is a very important topic. So why not also discuss here in this class？那另外就是说，原来今天是不上课的，所以我是就有可能有人没有来听课。那这样子的话，谈谈提案的题材的话，他们下次再上四十二章经课的时候，会比较不会落掉。Another reason is because that originally we were not planning to have this class today, but suddenly it changed to have a class. So I'm afraid that some people may not know that and they'll skip this class. And so I thought if I talk about different topic, then next time when they join the class, they didn't miss anything. 最后一个原因是因为下礼拜天那个论坛，我请了台湾那边的那个特教法师来谈关于这个方面的问题。那所以我就想到说，也许今天先谈一谈的话，大家在礼拜天听特教法师的讲法的时候会听得更入门，更能够进去。The last reason is because that this coming Sunday we'll have Dharma Sir Dejia from China, Taiwan to talk about similar topic. So I thought if I cover a bit of this, it will prepare everyone better to listen to her talk. So that's the three reasons we decided to talk about this. Okay. 那我们还是来传承释迦牟尼佛。So we'll still chant say Amitabha Buddha's name. No, Shakyamuni Buddha's name. We'll say the same English as before. Homage to our founding teacher, Shakyamuni Buddha. Homage to our founding teacher, Shakyamuni Buddha. Homage to our founding teacher, Shakyamuni Buddha. Homage to the Siddha Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Homage to the Siddha Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Homage to the Siddha Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. 无上甚深微妙法，百千万劫难遭遇。我今见闻得受持，愿解如来真实义。Spend the one's time, subtle and profound, various encounter, even billions of years. Now I see and hear it, accept and uphold it. May I truly understand the Buddha's actual meaning. Okay. 我自己是在10多年前有一阵子待在台湾，待了很长一段时间，1年多2年吧。那时候有机会就接触到安宁照顾这方面，所以就受训了。我在台大的安宁病房受训，所以。My training on this top subject was, this was a decade ago. I spent more than a year in Taiwan, and I had the chance to receive some training in the hospice work, National Taiwan University. And that's how I learned about this. 当初就在台大医院的。安宁病房，学着照顾一些病人。在那时候，在台大的安宁病房，他们有一个就是宗教师的培训课程。这个宗教师是他们称的叫宗教师，就是英文里头应该就是医院里头西方医院里头都有那个牧师 chaplain， 才帮助病人。那台湾是没有这个制度，那台大这边算是开放，他们开始有这个。So this is a program in the National Taiwan University Hospital, and they have a training program for chaplains. This is what they call the religious teacher. Okay. I think this is similar to the chaplaincy in the Western world. 但是这个很大的差别就是说，这个宗教是他培训的对象不是出家人，大部分都是佛教徒，比丘尼很多，但是也有天主教其他宗教，所以他们没有教，他们就基本上宗教是比较广泛一点，而不是说法师啊或者怎么样。So this program is kind of unique in Taiwan. It's not just for Buddhist monastics. They also accept other religions, for example, Catholic nuns. They also participate in this. When I was in the program, we had two Catholic nuns and received training together with us. 那我在受训的时候，是有两个天主教的修女和我们一起在受训，这两个修女还是越南籍的，但是他们在台湾已经有一阵子，所以中文也还可以跟得上。那这里我要跟大家介绍，就是说中间这个是陈庆余教授，他是这个计划的主要的推动人、主持人。是从前的那个家庭医学科的主任，先退下去了。And this doctor here is Dr. Chen. He was a chairman of the family practice in this National Taiwan University Hospital. He stepped down already, but he's still very active and involved. In this program is in the family practice. 那另外这两位比丘尼是这个宗教师，这个培训那个台柱，这个是中尊法师，他是主要的想法是他的推动。So these two bichunis are the main and cantors providing the training program. And this is Thomas Zhongdun. She is one of the pioneer in this program. He started this program. 那这个德嘉法师，大家，他是礼拜天会跟我们做讲法的。他是在这方面的训练很有经验，很有智慧，还帮助了很多很多病人。This is Thomas Gajah, the speaker of this coming Sunday, and she is very skillful, helping lots of dying patients. So 他们出了一本书叫《生死奥秘》，这个书在台湾很容易买到，不过在西方美国很难买到。你可以在 Google Play 的 eBook 上去买它的 eBook，不过这个 eBook 我不太会用，所以买了以后是不太管用。They wrote a book called The Mystery of Life and Death. This is Chinese only, but there's no English translation yet. Okay. There's an e-book in Google Play, still Chinese. And this is a very thorough discussion. 这本书是相当相当详细，有 200-300 页，嗯，将近到300页，almost like 300 pages，所以 it's very detailed。那另外就是回眸这个纪录片，我们1-2个月前曾经放过，的一些分支道场也都有这个纪录片，这个也是他们照顾病人的记录。So there's also the documentary called Review, and we played this a couple months ago. And our branch temples actually also have a copy of this. So these are the, I would say, the two references for this topic. Of course, you can probably find some in the English literature, but it's going to be different because it's not talking about Buddhist way of helping patients. So this is the documentary. 这个是回眸那个纪录片。那我要和大家谈一谈，就是我在受训的时候碰到的几个病人。那我们在那边受训，那边有3个多月的时间。那这个3个月的时间就是那边等于是个全职，每天从早到晚8点到5点，星期一到星期五。那我们一般就是要照顾个4个到5个的病人，When I received you can saw the internship there, more than 3 months, and we had to be there full time from 8 to 9 to 8 to 5, and 5 days a week, and we were assigned the 4 or 5 patients for us to take care. So what I'm going to share with you is that my experience, the patients that who I met, 那我要和谈谈我碰到的几个病人。这个病人，这个不是我的病人，但是我的一个病人是长得像这么壮一样。This is not my patient, but one of my patients were as strong as this guy. 但是呢，这个病人我碰到的时候呢，不是站着，是躺着的。He was lying on the bed。那他是我进去一看的时候。我就很自然说：“哇，你长得这么壮。”When I went into his room and I saw him such a strong person, so I can't stop myself by saying you are so strong。那你猜他怎么回？他怎么反应？他说：“没有用。”他用的是福建话讲的不好。His reply is。It's no use. And 那为什么他会这么说？So why he said so? Let's look at the question, right? Why the patient say that he has no use? It's no use. 那时候我在刚开始在受训，我不晓得他为什么他没有用。那我不晓得他为什么这么说，那我就没有办法帮助他，是不是？And I was a beginner that time, so I couldn't figure out why he said that. But because I don't know the reason why he said that, there's no use, and I couldn't really help him. So. You want to think about why you say that, okay? 大家可以想一想，为什么这个病人会这么说？OK，这么说，你要知道他为什么这样说，那才有办法帮助他。那接下来我要谈谈那个一般濒死的一些症状。So next, I want to talk about when someone is dying, what signs are there? You can see it, okay? And these few slides do not have English, but I have English slides later. 这个濒死的症状就是一般你到快要死的时候，身体的一些变化叫濒死症状。So first is to define what this is. This is just when one is about to die, and what kind of signs show up in his body. 那这边讲的就是说，可能会出现幻觉，食量会降低。OK。那喉咙会发出一些呼噜的声音，呼吸的形态会改变，血压会降低。So here is the patient may have hallucinations, and the appetite will decrease, reduce blood. The noisy breathing, the pattern of breathing be different, and the blood pressure will drop。那这病人对死亡会产生不安的恐惧，and they are fear of death。这个会对死亡产生不安和恐惧，我想这个很正常的，因为我们对未知的东西都会不安，都不知道，也不晓得会发生什么事情。尤其死亡这个东西更令人恐惧。I think this is very common because usually most people don't know what death is, right? So they are feel very uneasy, and they're scared. This is 比较详细的，并且讲到身体的功能会逐渐衰退，这个是很自然的，会没有办法走，然后会很嗜睡，so their body function will of course reduce and they become weak, they can walk，不容易侥幸，and sleep a lot。他们会刚刚讲幻觉，他们会躁动，会有可能会看到过去的亲人，甚至会大喊大叫的。So they are restless, and their of course their consciousness start. The function is clearly their mind will be confused. They may also see their relatives, past relatives, those are died already. They can even sometimes will yell and wave their hands. This 食欲降低，然后吞会有困难。那虽然食欲降低了，但是他们不会感觉到这是，那他们也不想吃东西，对。And their appetite will reduce. Many people will have difficulty swallowing. Even though they don't eat much, and they don't feel hungry. So as a caretaker, we don't want to force them to eat. 那你家属在旁边照顾的时候，你不要想一直要这个病人吃东西，那也不要要求医护人员 打点滴啊什么的，没有帮助，因为增加身体的负担。So the caretaker should don't ask the nurses or doctors to give some IV infusion nutrients. It's not helpful at all. They just increase the burden their body. 那这个呼吸，这个呼噜声呢？这个声音，在看过几个病人以后，你会很容易的分辨出来，很清楚的声音。这个声音一般是在很末期，就是病人都快往生前几天会听得到。And this noisy breathing, it's very clear, and you can easily recognize after some experience in the hospice bed, as it was. Usually, they appear at the very end of the life, so the patient was about to die. 那我们一般人亲属听到这个病人有这种声音的时候，我们都会觉得说他的一些喉咙的地方有东西卡住，所以我会要医务人员帮他们抽痰，就是有痰，但是这个实际上抽痰没有帮助，OK，而且还可能会导致出血。Caretaker usually will think there's some mucus in the throat of the patient. They will probably ask the nurse to suck out the mucus. But in fact, it's not the case. It doesn't help to do the suction, and the suction itself may even cause some bleeding. Okay. 那呼吸会变成不规律，okay. 他们会有时候会有好一段时间没有呼吸，so their breathing will become irregular, and they even have period times no breathing at all. 所以在呼吸的时候，一般会吸一口气，然后吐出去，吐出去以后可能会停了好长的一段时间，再吸一口气，然后再吐出去。So you'll probably observe they take a breath in, then breathe out, then stop there for a period of time before they take the next breath. Okay. 那我们知道这个呼吸啊，我们一般在健康的人呼吸，我们都不会留意到它，不会觉得是什么了不起的事情。但是当你身体很虚弱，像这种会临终的病人的时候，呼吸对他们是一个很不容易的事情。We healthy people don't notice our breathing, right? So it's spontaneous. But however, for the dying, breathing becomes an effort to do that. 呼吸本身其实需要能量，是吸气方面，因为你吸气的时候是要让你的胸腔扩大，气体才能够进，空气才能够进到肺。那你要让胸腔扩大的时候，你必须把横膈膜收缩往下去，然后你肋骨要往上提。那这个横膈膜收缩和肋骨往上提，这个都是肌肉收缩。肌肉收缩需要能量，这个能量对于健常人而言，能量用的不多，但是对病人而言，很虚弱的体质，这个能量变成是一个很大的负担。Now when we breathe and we breathe in, we need to enlarge our chest so that the air will come in to the to our lungs. And to expand your chest, you have to lower your diaphragm, which is a muscle you have to contract. And also you will raise your rib cage. That also needs the muscle to contract. The contraction of muscle use energy. Okay. And that energy may be nothing to the healthy individuals, but it can be a burden. Can be quite a lot of effort and energy to the dying. And 就是这样子，所以这个他们呼出去以后，真的要等了一阵子，然后再吸进来，才有那个力量再把气再吸进去。So I think that's one reason why you see that after breathe out, they'll stop it, which will take a break, right? Then breathing. Okay. 那这个血压会降低，那手脚将会冰冷，有时候皮肤会有很湿很凉凉的，你去摸它的话，很湿，然后很凉。The blood pressure of course will drop. Right? And usually their hands and feet will become cold. If you touch the skin, you feel it's moist and cold. Okay? And the pulse, you may not even be able to feel it because blood pressure is so low. 那你去量他脉搏的话，去碰了，也许他摸不出来，因为血压太低了。另外就是尿液会减少，排尿会困难。那个尿液的颜色会变深，有时候一天只有排尿1次到2次。And the urine will decrease, and the color will become dark because the kidney function so you got it turned bad. And sometimes they'll probably just have pee for 1 or 2 times a day. Sometimes it's difficult to pee. So the following are the English. 下面这些是英文的，但是内容是差不多。So this 1 to 3 months. Then you can English speaker, you can read it. Don't need to explain it. 这是它分作1到3月，3个月之间，很多东西都是我们从前谈过的。This is the website copy from，就是那个。网站，这是1到2个月之前，是食量减少，那个肠胃的蠕动就减少，尿液少，血压降低，呼吸。先走动，Just talking about hallucination. When they can see the loved ones, their relatives that died long time ago. 那他们有的会产生幻觉，看到那个。已经过世很久的亲人，okay. 那他们看到这个的时候呢，我们不要去跟他讲说没有这回事情，okay. 那一个原因就是说，你那样讲的话， 他会不相信你，他反而会生气。So he has said that don't convince them that these visions are real. Okay? So they won't be happy. And he has said that this kind of vision actually make them happy. 那看到过去的亲人呢，他们反而会让这病人心情会比较好，所以也不需要去否认这个东西。但事实上，他们也许是真的看到，只是我们没有看到而已。OK，so、okay. as a matter of fact, they may have actually see these relatives. It's only us who don't see them. Okay? This is in the last few days. And we'll continue. I think this is an important point here. Even though these patients are about to die, they usually are in coma and sleeping, but they can still hear, feel. 那我们佛教经典里头是这样讲的，就说人的那个听觉是最晚消失的，所以即使病人，你看他在昏睡，你不要就不理他，要跟他们谈，因为他们可以听得到。你如果不跟他们谈的话，他们觉得很孤，被遗弃的感觉。So in the sutra does say that hearing is the last sense faculty and leave our body. So even though the patient may be sleeping or in coma, they can still hear us. So don't ignore them, and we need to keep talking to them and see if they can hear us. If we ignore them, they'll feel ignored and they feel sad and lonely. 这个是到最后，最后呢，是这病人他那个会有很多精神状态出来，会哭啊、叫啊什么的。是这边的告诉我们说，我们不要离开他们，OK，好，能够想办法让能够安静下来，用那个比较柔和的音乐，用那温和的去碰触他们。So here say that we should stay with these patients, the dying, and keep them calm with soothing music, gentle touch. And for Buddhists, we can play the Buddha's Bodhisattva's name, right? It's even better than the worldly music. 那我们佛教徒，你可以放佛号，或菩萨的圣号，那比一般的这种世俗的音乐会更好。这边讲就在这个房间里头，应该是亮着，OK，但是当然也不要太亮，要是个安静的，越安静越好。那你要让病人晓得说， 你一直在那里陪伴着他们。OK，真的。So let's talk about the room. You weld it to bright, keep as quiet as possible. Constantly assure that you are there. So you just to keep talking to them, touch them, and so that they know that you are with them. 这边讲到的就是听觉，我刚刚讲的，对不对？就是说，现在这个大家看中文的人，你可以看了，我就不用多讲了，你的把它翻译成英文。So this is talking about hearing. We talked about earlier, something about playing the Buddha's name. This is what I just talked about. You see past relatives, so you have to. If he tells you that he sees past relatives, you should be very concentrated to listen to him. 不要不当一回事，OK。So let's talking about when the patient talking to you about what they saw, the relatives, and who had passed by already. Your right attitude is listen attentively, OK。Don't say you disagree, say that's not right. This is in the Fifth Chapter. The Fifth Chapter has about this problem. This is taken from the Earth Source Chart. I have the English translation here. This 亦有百千恶道鬼神，我变作父母，乃至诸眷属，迎接亡人变作恶道，何况本造恶者。When those who do good in Chambudipa are about to die, hundreds of thousands of ghost spirits from the lower path transform themselves and appear as their parents or other relatives in an attempt to lead such people to fall into the lower path. How much more is that the case for those who have done evil deeds? 这第三经里头这边讲得很清楚，你这个做善事的人，即使做善的人，到命中的时候，都有很多的恶道的鬼神，他们会变成这个临终人的过去的父母或者亲友。来接他们，这样子他们才会跟他去到恶道去。So that's from the Earth Store Sutra, said that even those who do get these, when they are about to die, there are many ghosts and spirits will transform themselves, appear as the patient's parents or other relatives. 那他们。这些恶道鬼神为什么要变作这个病人的亲属家人呢？因为这样子的话，这个病人才会跟着去了，对不对？病人看到他的过去的父母，很高兴啊，就跟着去了，去了就落到三恶道去。So the reason is very simple, right? When we see our As parents, we are very happy. We are follow them, and that will lead us to fall into the lower paths, like animals, ghosts, even fall into the. 所以说，这个病人说他看到过去的亲人，这个是有根据的，只是我们看不到而已。So from the sutra, you know that this dying patient see their parents, which this is true. It's only us who don't have the vision to see them. like the patient decision. Okay, so don't argue and say they are wrong. They are right. We are wrong. Okay, you are wrong.那这个第三点就继续讲说，这个出眷属当于设搭供养转轮出经，念佛菩萨名号，如是善缘能令亡者离诸恶道，诸魔鬼神悉皆退散。So the earth those which are continuously relatives of those deceased people should make generous offerings, recite the sacred sutras, and recite the names of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Such good condition can cause the deceased to leave the lower path, and all the demons, ghosts, and spirits will withdraw and disperse. 告诉我们说，那你这个，这个病人的亲属呢，应该要适当供养，供养他们三宝，然后读经啊，念佛号或菩萨的名号。那你能够造这个功德的话，就会一方面会让这个亡者离诸恶道。就是那个来找他，找这个过去的亲属，会离开恶道。那诸魔鬼神呢，悉皆退散。这些鬼神呢，退散以后，这个临终的人就不会下那到恶道去了，对不对？So the sutra instructs us that the relatives of the deceased people should make generous offerings. Recite the sutras and recite Buddha's Bodhisattva's name. That could, the merit and virtue created this way will cause the deceased to leave the lower path, and those demon spirits will disappear so that the dying won't fall into the hells. Okay, so this is a, I think, a good advice for us. So this is a 很重要的一个，对，其实开始，这个我刚刚讲过了。So this just talking about it. When the patient don't want to eat, don't force them to eat. Okay. 这个是劝说他这个。我觉得他的病人的手脚冷的时候，要用毛毯，不是用毛毯，不要用这种暖暖包或电热毯，以免过热造成烫伤。So this is suggest don't use the electric blanket for the patient. So it may cause burn to the patient skin. 那是 talking about urine juice。那这边会讲到，就是说，像很欢道谢、道歉、道爱、道别，okay？ 这个适合他们叫做四道，So in the program, they emphasize this a lot. The four things you need to say, okay, that's to say thank you, say sorry, say you love them, say goodbye. 那这个 是一般病人刚到安宁病房的时候，他们还很清楚。所以我们会和这个病人们谈的，就是说去谈谈他一生的回顾，从小到老一生的回顾。So when the patient has admitted to the hospice wards, usually they are still conscious and they can talk. And what we usually do, we'll talk to them and suggest them to recollect, recall their life from very young to old. Okay. 那在这个生命回顾的过程里头，他会想起一些很快乐的事情，也会想到，他得到什么恩情，什么人对他有恩。对不对？那对于什么恩的时候，你就要建议他们说要跟这些人呢也道谢。对、okay.，So when they recall their life, they may recall the people who help and those who help them will suggest them to say thanks, thank you to them. Okay. 那这个道谢，他们能够当面道谢，那是最好。但是病人往往没有办法这样做，至少你在书信上、电话里头，甚至就在心里头都可以。Okay. Of course, the best thing to say thank you is to do it face to face, but this patient usually don't have that. Cannot do that. So they can make phone call, okay, or send mail, things like this. If they can even do that, they can express their thanks in their heart. It's good enough. 那在生命回顾的过程里头，他们也有可能想到他们对哪些人对不起。你对不起的话，就要建议他们和这些人道歉。And when they recall their life, they may also recall those people they did something wrong to them. And so they have to say sorry to them and apologize to them. 那 道爱就是对他们的亲友，他们应该父母亲啊，那个孩子啊。表示他们这个病人表示对他们的爱，and of course they want to express their love to their loved ones。那最后才说才是告别，最后 then finally say goodbye to their loved ones。那这个不光是说病人 可以这样做，对病人可以道歉。道歉、道爱、道别，那照顾他的人、亲属也可以这样做。So it's not only the patients can say all these, do these four things. The relatives, the kids, can also say this to the patient. 那我们可以跟这个病人道谢，因为他是我们的父母亲，对不对？能谢谢他们照顾吗？那如果我们做错了什么，对，做错了什么事情，我们跟他道歉，那我们对我们的亲人，要跟他说我们爱他，最后是道别。And of course, we want to thanks the patient if they are very kind to us, like our parents, right? And to us, thanks to them. And if we do something wrong and to them, then we'll apologize to them and we'll express our love to them. And finally, goodbye. 那这些做这件事情，还有生命回顾，对他们而言其实是很重要。要不然的话，他会有包袱带着走。对，你要道谢的人没有道谢，我觉得。过不去。道歉的人没有道歉，他会觉得过不去。This is a very important process because if they don't do this, they'll have something in their heart, still feel that they haven't said thanks to those people who are kind to them, and they haven't apologized to those who Ramos。So this is important。那生命回顾另外一个好处就是说，他会想起过去很多很高兴的事情、快乐的事情。那这些病人的话，他的心情、精神会好的很多，因为在这个安宁病房，他们晓得这个自己身体的状况怎么样，日子也不多了，所以一般会相当消沉。那如果他们能够回想起过去这个灿烂的时光的话，那对他们精神上会有很大帮助。The one good thing about lapse review is that they most always recall happy time people. They will help them to raise their spirits, because most people are depressed and they are admitted to the hospice ward. They know they are dying. And so they feel hopeless. But when they can review the life, they still see that they were happy time before, then we'll help them raise their spirit. 另外一个病人，我也很快要谈的，就是这是一个病人。这个病人呢，我进去他病房的时候，他在问我说：“法师，你看。”我能不能够往生极乐世界？The next patient I want to story I want to share with you is this is a patient. When I enter in his room, he asked me this question. So, Master, will I be reborn in the then or ultimate place? 这个是一个佛教的，对。Of course, he was a Buddhist. Now, if patient asks you this question, how do you answer? So, how do you answer him? If you were me, and then he asks you this question, 我不记得我怎么回答他。那时候，我想我也没有。太好的答案。I don't recall what I how I answered his question, but I think I probably don't have a good answer either, because I was a beginner. I couldn't really lack wisdom to help him. 那回答这个问题，我想谈谈那个观无量寿佛经。So to answer that question, I want to talk about this sutra, contemplating the last night Buddha. 我想有些人对这部经大概也蛮熟悉的。这是讲到那个九品往生。This sutra talking about the ninth grade, the lotus ninth grade, reborn in the Western period and in ninth grade. 那么很快的看过去，它这个九品就是有上品、中品和下品。那每品里头又分成三圣，对，所以上品、上圣、上品中圣、上品下圣。So there are three grades: upper grade, middle grade, and lower grade. Within each grade, there are three sublevels. Literally, say upper birth, middle birth, lower birth. So there's a total of nine grades, nine levels. 那我们用这个学校的评分呢，会比较更容易了解。这个上品就是 A 嘛，中品是 B，下品是 C。So if we use the grading system, it'll be easier to understand. There'll be the upper grade is A, middle grade is B, lower grade is C. Then you have A plus, minus, A minus, etc. 在每 A 里头有 A 加 A 减等等，所以就变。那我们上品的我们就不要去看它，因为上品和我们今天要谈的这个题材没有什么关系。So we will We are not going to talk about the upper grade because the upper grade has nothing to do with our discussion today. We start with the middle grade, 那从中品这边来，中品这边就是中品上身，这是毕加，这个是佛教徒，那受的五戒，那八关斋戒，他没有造什么恶，他只要用这个是。他持戒这些功德，三根回向，愿求生西方极乐世界。So these are the Buddhists. They observe the five precepts. They precept and they transfer the merit in the Western Pure Land. That's in the they'll be reborn in the Pure Land with B plus. 那样子的话，他们。就可以西方极乐世界去，就是中品的上身。那中品中身呢？这个是我们应该比较熟悉的，这是在八关斋戒的时候，你一日一夜求八关斋戒，然后把这个功德回向，就可以升到极乐世界去，中品中身。So the level B, the grade B is, I think, that's it. People is more familiar with this one. It's for the eight precepts. When you uphold the eight precepts one day and one night, and you transfer the merit to, then you're able to reborn in the Western Pure Land. 那中品下生呢？这个不是佛教徒，但是他一般世界上的好人，他很孝顺父母，他很仁爱，他也很热心。And for the B minus, these are not Buddhists, but they are good people in the world. They are filial to their parents, and they are very good people in the world. Okay. 那他们怎么会往生到极乐世界去？就是他命运中时候遇到善知识，那善知识跟他广说阿弥陀佛国度的乐事。另外讲的法藏就是八个大愿。So how do these people can reborn in the pure land? They are not Buddhists, right? But they may meet a good teacher, good friend. They explain to them the happiness of the Western pure land and also the 48 great vows. 他听到这些开示以后，命中的就是到极乐世界去。OK，having、okay. heard about this, and they'll be reborn in the Western Pure Land. OK，so、okay. it's not, they are not Buddhists, and they can because the good teacher help them. OK，那讲到下品呢，下品这个是造恶业的。就是造诸恶业，那虽然不毁谤这个大乘经典，但是他们还是，如果他还能够碰到善知识，赞叹大乘十二部经首的名字，So the for the lower grade, these are not good people at all. They commit various evil acts, and if he's lucky enough, he made a good teacher praise the title of the 12th division of the Mahayana Sutra. 听了这些经名呢，他可以除去千劫的恶业。Having heard about the title of the sutra, the thousand karmas, the evil karma would be 外报，然后呢，这个善知识又叫他，合掌，称南无阿弥陀佛。那称这个阿弥陀佛的圣号呢，可以除掉50亿劫生死的罪。Then the good teacher also advise him to put their palms together and say Buddha's name, Amitabha Buddha's name. Okay. by saying Amitabha Buddha's name, the evil karma extinguished. About 50 kalpas, kotis, I'm sorry, 50 kotis of kalpas. This is about kotis 10 million. So this would be 10 million billion actually. This is 5 billion kalpas.这个就是刚刚讲的那个下品上身。那到时候呢，佛会选这个化火还有化菩萨来接他，OK，接他几个进去，OK，so the when they are about to die, the Amitabha Buddha will send a transformed Buddha's Bodhisattva to welcome this person to the wisdom building。下品众生呢，这个是更是恶人。OK，the see this is even more evil。那但是他那个遇到善知识，赞颂阿弥陀佛的实力为德，赞佛的光明神力，赞戒定慧解脱之境。And this the his Siddhamaka teacher praise the Amitabha Buddha's ten powers. And also the spiritual power of the Buddha, and also praise the precept, samadhi and wisdom, liberation, etc. And from here that he will be able to reborn in the Pure Land as well. 那因为这样的原因，他就可以升到极乐世界去。那最后就是下品下生，这些这个是个大恶人，五逆十恶，对，都做了。And these are the C minus. This is very evil people. They commit the five grave offenses, heinous offenses, so 10 evil things. They are supposed to fall into the hells. 那他也碰到善知识，善知识呢教他念佛，但是这个人呢，因为太痛苦了，他没有办法念佛。那这个善知识就想说，那你没有办法念佛了，你就称归灭无量寿佛。So and this person also very lucky to meet a good teacher. The good teacher urged him to be mindful of the Buddha, but he is too painful to do that, feel too pain. So the good teacher advised him, and if you cannot concentrate on the Buddha, then you should say homage to Amitabha, Buddha. 这个归命无量寿佛，归命就是南无嘛，南无就是归命，无量寿佛就是阿弥陀佛，这个就是称佛阿弥陀佛的圣号。所以一般讲念佛不一定就是念佛号，是称佛号这个才是。So that's actually homage is Namo. Amitabha is Buddha is Amitabha Buddha. So this is we say Namo Amitabha. 这边就讲得更清楚。要自心令身不绝，具足十念称南无阿弥陀佛，称名佛名故，念念中就除却81劫生死的罪。So here says very clear, homage to Amitabha. It's actually his Chinese say Namo Amitabha. And because you say this Buddha, Amitabha Buddha's name, it's the 那卡玛，手动 AT cortisol extinguish，那就是就讲到他怎么样升到七十四节去，是好容易的，是漂亮。那这个就是刚刚下品上身称佛名是51节是最下品的呢。成佛名说81节是不是？所以 this is just a summary of what we had before this the power of reciting Amitabha Buddha's name. So we have a table here, and next one is the English. We always go to the person. 那我们前面这篇我们就不看它，主要是要看后面这四品。后面这四品，他们都除了这一品是还是好人以外，这边都是坏人。那他们呢也不懂得发愿，因为不是，那也不是佛教徒，但是他们能够吸到极乐世界去，是因为碰到善知识。对，所以你临终的时候，所以助念是很重要。那助念的话，不是光念佛号，你要开示，就是前面这些都是因为开示的关系，称佛名号只有这两品是称佛名号。另外两品没有成功，但是还可以那几件事情，但是这四品都是有开始。So we are not going to talk about these labels. We are talking about these lower labels, lower grades. And this is a B minus. This is a good person. Okay, but these are evil ones. They still don't read the pure name. But you notice all these four grades, they met good teacher and instruct them and give them instructions. So when we go to recite Buddha's name for the dying or deceased, and not only we recite Buddha's name, you should give talk. So you see this, only these two labels, these two grades, you recite Buddha's name. And these two grades, they don't recite Buddha's name. But all four of them receive instructions. So instructions are very important when you go to hell, dying, you should definitely give talk to this patient. Dying. 这个我就先跳，等会就不讲。所以我们说这个临终助念是很重要的。So that's why that's a, say that we help patient dying recite Buddha's name for them is very important. This is also from Crystal Sutra, talking about the power of reciting Buddha's name. So, 未来现在诸众生的命中日得闻一佛名、一菩萨名、一时佛名，无论有罪无罪，悉得解脱。你临终的时候，只要听到一个佛名、菩萨名，都可以得到解脱。So, here is said that the on the verge of dying, hear the name of one Buddha, Bodhisattva or Pratya Buddha. They attain liberation with the name committed. So now, and I am going to share with you the third patient, and this will be the last patient I share with you. 这个是个佛像，那个在安宁病房， 有很多这个佛像，有大的小的。那病人来的时候，我们经常会把给他这个病人一个佛像，就放在吊在他看得到的地方。And we have several of these Buddha images in the painting in the hospital. And when the patient got admitted, usually we'll give them one of these hanging next to their bed so that they can see them very clearly. 那我有一个病人，这个年纪是比较大的，80几岁了。他进来的时候就没有办法讲话。然后那时候是要过年的，要，所以过年的时候我也没有过去。同时呢，我那时候受训也期满，所以我过完年也没有过去。但是我给了这个病人挂了什么烟火佛像在那边。So this patient was admitted just before Chinese New Year, and it's a holiday in the year, and so I didn't go there. And it happened to be the end of my internship there as well, so I didn't go even after the Chinese New Year. 那后来呢？过年以后呢？有一天我有一件事情跑到那个安宁病房去，那很意外的接到一通电话，and several days after the New Year, I happened to visit the hospital, and surprisingly, I received a phone call from this patient's daughter. 那这个。他这个女儿呢，听到我接的电话，她非常非常的兴奋。她说她父亲原来是戴着假牙，但是假牙呢，那因为病人嘛，那假牙拿掉，所以他的脸是凹进去的，不是这样圆满，对不对？但是他的父亲往生以后，他们助念到后头，他那个脸整个饱满起来，就像阿弥陀佛那个佛像一样，同时年纪大的人都有什么老人斑嘛，点一点的，那这个老人斑也不见了。所以这个女儿，她这个女儿就很确定说，这个她父亲是往生到极乐世界去。And the patient's daughter said that the patient more danger. And of course, in the hospital, you don't wear denture anymore. So his cheeks is kind of, it's not full like this at all, right? But after the recitation, Buddha said, after his father passed away, and his father face become full, round like this. Besides some of the spots, his skin becomes so smooth and radiant. So the daughter was pretty sure that his father was reborn in the Western period. So she was so happy. Okay, she was very happy. 那这里我们。为什么这个人会进到极乐世界？我们讲是观相念佛，这是一个观相念佛，对不对？可以是观相念。你 besides recite Buddha's name, you can also watch the Buddha image and mind for the Buddha. That's one another way of this mind for the Buddha. 那这边我要带到的一个问题就是说，他这个。病人往生，结果他女儿很高兴，是女儿是不孝顺吗？So, see, the patient died, and his daughter was so happy. So, the daughter had failure? Not really. The daughter was really failure. Okay, so why he, she was so happy? Because she thought her father was reborn in the Western period.所以我们在佛教里头，我们讲死亡，我们讲往生了，对不对？往生是什么意思？往生是去投胎啊，去出生，对不对？那你如果能够升到好的地方，遇上极乐世界的话，那不是也可以庆生的吗？是不是？所以，in Buddhism, we don't say die, we say be reborn, is you go somewhere to be born again. And if you can be reborn in a better place, or even like Western people, then is that worthwhile happiness, right? So you need to celebrate birthday, right? So that's why I think the death itself can turn into a happy event. It's not necessary to be sad. 所以这个死亡可以是一件高兴的事情，而不是伤心的事情，不是。所以这点呢，我觉得是我们在帮助这个，临终的人，或是就是寿命快尽的人啊，从这边去跟他们开导，会有很大的帮助。So I think this is a very important point. You can help the dying to inspire them instead of feel depressed. 因为你就像原来这个病人，我这个电话讲一下。Before we talk about, I just mention this quickly. 另外，我稍微提一下，就是说，我们一般就是念阿弥陀佛的声号，但是如果这个亲属或者是病人不信佛的话，你念阿弥陀佛的声号，那个病人会不高兴，亲属会更不高兴，因为很多人会觉得说，念阿弥陀佛声号是都要走的人，或已经走的人，那他会觉得说你在催他的亲人赶快走，所以他还可能把你赶走。So the some non-Buddhists may not like the Amitabha Buddha's name at all, because many people will think that you recite Amitabha Buddha's name only when you die or about to die, right? So they'll get angry, actually probably kick you out. You're not welcome. 在这种家庭的话，我建议你可以念观音菩萨圣号，因为观音菩萨圣号，一般人不会有这种感觉，大家对观音菩萨也都很亲切，所以在这种情形下念观音菩萨圣号会有帮助。And in situation like this, I suggest that you recite Guanyin Zen, because people won't have that kind of bad feeling about Guanyin Bodhisattva. 那另外上人讲过，你这个西方三圣，你念哪一圣都可以升到极乐世界去嘛。And the master said that the three sages in the Western Pure Land, no matter which sage you recite their name, you'll be able to reborn in the Pure Land. Okay, so that's just a side trip. So 这边很快的看过，就是说你要怎么去帮助这个临终的人。要了解临终和死亡的过程，为病人讲解，这样子病人的恐惧会消除。So how do you help the dying? You need to understand the dying process and the death, so that you can explain that to the patients. Then patient won't have fear, right? 那了解临终病人及家人的心灵需求，understand the patients and also the relatives。你要有倾听的技巧，这个去听他，我们要好好的听。You need to develop your skill of listening，了解死后的世界，为病人了解，这个病人就会恐惧就会消除。So you understand the underworld and you can expand that to the patient so that patient won't feel better, won't have fear. 最后就是你要培养自己的智慧，增强帮助病人的求生能力。这个就是要自己，要靠自己的修行，我们才有智慧帮助病人。And then you have to enhance your wisdom so that you can help the patients. 那最后我们回到这个病人，and let's return to the first patient I met. 那现在大家觉得你怎么去回答这个病人？So now after the discussion within an hour, so how do you answer this patient when you say he's no use, he's not useful anymore? 那你这病人说他没有效了，不好，没有用，那你怎么去帮助他？如果从刚刚这个讲的，你这个可以跟他开导说他其实他还有前途，对不对？他能够升到极乐世界去的话，他前途很光明啊。所以他有一个目标，也是一个很好的目标，很快乐的目标。那这样子他就不会觉得说怎么消沉，他觉得他这辈子就没有用。I think one thing we can talk to the patient is that we talked earlier, right? He still have hope. He has hope to be reborn in the Western paradigm. That's a really good place to go. And if he understands that, then he won't feel depressed. He can still work hard to achieve that goal. So we can turn that around. Now, 我想我就谈到这边。那接下来看看大家有没有什么问题，我们可以讨论一下。So I think I will stop here. And if you have questions, you can bring that up. Mm-hmm. 现在用这个时间和大家看看礼拜天的演讲。So talk about the coming Sunday. This is the third lecture of the forum. 这个论坛的第三个讲演，讲到这个德加法师。德加会的讲演，他讲的是生死奥秘，就是那本书的书名。So the topic is the history of life and death. This is the title of the book. Same Zoom link, but this is going to be English simultaneous translation because she'll speak in Mandarin. And those who don't understand Mandarin, you have to go to the English room. 听华语的人是个好消息，因为他是用华语来讲法。 所以你不需要去中文的去听中文的翻译，这次是换到听英文的人要去听中文的翻译。搜索 YouTube，现在那个 YouTube 上头。Okay，any questions？有没有什么问题？都没有问题吗？If not, we'll dedicate Mary about it. If not, we'll dedicate Mary about it. 其实也没有什么能力帮助这些病人，而是因为我想了解这个临终的过程。这样子到时候当我到那个地步的时候，我晓得会发生什么事情，什么什么。I want to add something that the reason why I participate in that training program was not because that I want to practice Bodhisattva paths. I want to help patients. I knew I don't have the skill to help patients. And to be honest, my purpose was to learn the process of dying. So that when I'm in the next stage, I know what's going to happen. I can handle that better. Okay. 所以，那确实是这样。所以我就其实，在受训期间，我学了很多东西。那这些病人，其实我对他们帮助并不大。这是确实是这样。So I did learn a lot from these patients. So they are all my teachers. They show what's happening to them. And I learned from them. So I didn't really help them much at all. 那这些病人都是我的老师啊，他们现身说法，所以那我才能够晓得说这个在这个过程是怎么样。刘瑞，你把这个问题念一念吧。我的这个前提是我看得很吃力。
它不是问题，只是一个 comment。
Comment？ 什么样的 comment？
他就讲一下他自己，他的外婆当时临终的情况。
需不需要翻译？那这个薛平他讲什么？能把这启发给我？
如果需要，我可以读他的，不需要也没关系。
那是什么集？这集发给我？
哦，这。薛就是可能是问那个
视频啊，我不是每次都会发吗？你有没有在我们的 email list？ 那个电邮的主的话，我每次都会发的。你如果OK， 你给我 email address。 如果没有其他的话，我们就没有其他的吗？没有的吧。
没有。
那我们就来回向吧，好吧？这样看中文啊。悉发菩提心，见思义报身，众生皆难过。谁还 pause？我也用 respect to the Venerable Master。阿弥陀佛。